Hello, I am Squid of Love. Welcome back. Today we are going to take a look at Stellaris, a new grand strategy title from the Masters of the Xanon Paradox, which may look at first like another 4X game, but in reality has a lot more similarities with titles such as Europa Universalis and Crusader Kings. There are a ton of interesting features in Stellaris, but my favorite one has to be the exploration system. A very well-made and deep exploration system that will make each of your playthroughs feel unique. So let's go ahead and start the new game and take a look at Stellaris. The game gives you the opportunity, the ability to play as one of the existing races, as one of the existing species. But what makes Stellaris more fun is the fact that you can create your own empire. You can choose everything about your empire, from their appearance, how they will look like, to their names, to their city appearances, and their ships. So let's go and create our new empire, our very brand new empire, and see what we can do in Stellaris. After we have chosen their appearance and their names and the names for the ships, the cities and stuff like that, we can choose some traits for them, some positive and some negative traits in order to balance the race. This will make our species a lot more interesting, and it will also affect our playstyle. You can choose whatever you like. So for example, I have chosen intelligent, quick learners, but somehow we have to compensate for these two positive traits with a negative. So this is why I have chosen the non-adaptive. That has to do with the worlds and which worlds we can colonize and how easily we can do it at the beginning. Also very important is the government and the ethics we can choose for our empire. This will also affect our gameplay. So for example, I have chosen a militarist that will help us be a bit more aggressive, and a military dictatorship that we don't have to hold elections quite often, but when our ruler is dying, we will have to elect a new ruler. Of course, we can choose more. We can make a combination of all these ethics, and each different government gives different bonuses. So for example, military dictatorship can increase our naval capacity plus 20%, ship upkeep minus 5%. It is obviously the best if you want to be aggressive. But if we choose a divine mandate, we can gain a higher tolerance to slavery when we are enslaving other species, and less cost for resettlement. So our Squidian Empire is ready, and we can go ahead and start playing. We have also chosen our favorite weapons, which are going to be lasers, and the appearance of our ships. We are pretty much ready to go. Let's save the empire and start a new campaign. And we are ready to start our adventures, our space adventures, with our unique looking and very weird empire, the Squidian Empire. In the eons since the first primitive space squid communities took space in the archipelagos and lagoons of Laginchu, our civilization has spread and prospered. Countless nation states formed as we advanced through the technological ages, warring against each other until only one remained. Although the fighting was often brutal, those who survived nurtured a martial tradition that has prevailed to this day. Now, after the successful creation of several experimental subspace fields, the finest minds of the Squidian Empire have finished development of the first warp drives. The stars themselves are finally within our grasp. Welcome, let's begin. Tips only. It is very good that the game features a very nice tutorial. It makes it easier for newcomers to the genre to start playing the game. For example, games like Europa Universalis and Crusader Kings from Paradox, again, are quite hard to get into. Stellaris is a lot more easier. The game is not turn-based. If you have played these other games, you will be familiar with how the game plays. It is real-time. You can pause it, you can increase the speed, and you can slow it down. And this will affect your gameplay. This will give you the opportunity to give commands, to choose your next plan, choose your next resources. So the first thing we are going to do, first of all, if you are a new player, you want the full tutorial. It will teach you the game, it will teach you what each one of these these panels do. The empire, where you can see your empire, your leaders, and the factions inside your empire. You're annoying me, robot. The contacts. Who have we met and how we can communicate with them. The ship designer, where we can design our own ships. There are limited designs we can do. So for example, when we unlock new weapons, we can try to put them on our vessels. Or the same goes with the reactors, etc, etc. We can create totally new designs. And this is also another great feature. It adds customization to the game. Situation log, where we can see our objectives and the victory conditions, of course. And of course our technology, where we do research in order to find and build better stuff. So let's select new researches. This is very important, the colony ship. As soon as we get a colony ship, the sooner we will start colonizing other planets. But first we have to find them, and we are going to start finding them right now. As for here, I'm gonna try to reveal this resource, which is a strategic resource. When we start the game, we have three fleets. Our science ship.
This is our science ship.
Yeah, I know. Which is something like a scout. We have a scientist on board the science ship. And what we are going to do with our science ships mainly is explore the universe. This is where we start. It's not a big universe. It's the default for this game, just to take a look around. So what we're going to do is try to survey the system. Our science ships will continue surveying all the objects on this system, our system. And when it's done, we will know what kind of resources we can find around here. As for the construction ship, when we find some resources on a planet, we can build outposts, we can build mining factories, and we can extract these resources. Now, let's unpause and go on. This is our credits. Our energy acts as credits as well, so we will need to be careful. We will need not to go minus, not to start losing them, or else we will have problem. Minerals are for building stuff, building ships, building buildings. Influence is very important for buying, for recruiting new leaders. And these are our research points for the three different kind of researches. The more we have, we can also find them by exploring. The more we have, the better for us. We can control directly 5 planets. We can have up to 14 vessels. And this is the strategic resources we have. We haven't found any yet. We have to discover them and then take advantage of them. Military fleets, are you? Our armies, our fleets. We can order them around. We can tell them to go in other systems. We can attack, and it will be our main card in trying to survive and enslave or destroy other civilizations, other species. Not the best system so far. We haven't found anything already. Let's take a look on our home world. Oh, you robot. Well, here we can see how much food we have, extra food, what are our resources. Our world is an ocean world, which means we should be looking for ocean worlds to colonize. Our science ship has found energy credits, so we are going to build with our construction ship a mining station here. Yeah, we keep finding resources. If we take a look on the map, this is how worlds with resources look like. And when we build mining stations above the planetary objects that has these resources, the numbers will go green. And that means that we are taking advantage of them. When we build the mining stations,
an anomaly. From time to time, our science ship
This is one of the most important parts of the game, finding anomalies, finding stuff that are very interesting. We can have our scientist explore. Elder has gained a level. It would be wise to pause the game when you find something interesting like this anomaly, and we can stop our survey of the system and have him research the anomaly. And this is exactly what we will do. We can find some interesting stuff that will help our research, that will help us survive and prosper. Let's go back to the world. Let's pause, go to the surface. Here we can see what kind of resources has our planet and what kind of population we have. In order to take advantage of the resources, the population has to be on that tile. Every planet has a different number of tiles, and you can see that these are blocked. Some of these are blocked. We can clear them. We can research the technology to clear them. It's not very wise to start wasting resources on clearing the tiles at the beginning. So we're just gonna leave it. Speed up the game a bit and wait for our new finds. Let's take a look at the research. We need 51 months in order to unlock the colony ship and start creating it. But I think we should start building a new science ship and start exploring the systems around us first. This is where we manage all ground forces. Here we can... Okay, let's take a look at the anomaly. We found a natural formation on Gurasim. Stunning in its geometrical perfection, this is surely a divine sign marking our way out toward the stars. We should continue to investigate these sorts of anomalies whenever we get the chance. They will most assuredly grant us new knowledge and technology. Praised be the divine. Pause and go to the situation log. No entries, unfortunately. If something interesting appears and we will have to do something specific, it will appear over there. We can start researching it. How is the mining station going? It is at 93%. Let's go back to the armies. Here we can recruit new armies that will help defend our world in case we are under attack, or we can create assault armies and have them in a transport ship, take them in a hostile system and invade it, try to capture the world. Wait, and the spaceport. Here we can build new ships. We can build military ships, construction ships, science ships, and of course the colony ship when it will be unlocked. I'm gonna create a new science ship and I'm gonna also send it out there exploring our universe. Mining station is complete. We can continue by creating another one on this asteroid which has two minerals. Build mining station. The more resources we can collect, the better for us. At this part of the game, the beginning, we can... What is this? Fleet order finished. Okay. At this part of the game, we can only colonize Ocean World successfully. Our happiness will be 100% in Ocean Worlds. So, what we are looking for with our space... with our science seems are these worlds, so we can start colonizing and expanding our borders and our influence. Nice resources here. Let's see what else. Well, it is wise to not run the game at fast all the time and always pause it when something happens so you can take a look at it. At the beginning it could be chaotic. It could be very hard to keep following everything. But after a while, you will have absolutely no problem. Spaceport. So we have a new science ship. And we are gonna send it here. We have to assign a leader. We don't have any available leader for our second science ship. So we can recruit one. This will cost us influence. And each one of these leaders have their own age, obviously, you have to remember that it is a grand strategy. Stellaris is a grand strategy game. It will take centuries to complete the game. Centuries in game, obviously. Your leaders and your scientists will die eventually. So that guy is 45, will die sooner than the others two, if nothing bad happens to the others two. Also, each leader has its own unique abilities, so expertise materials, he's good for research speed, spark of genius, and archaeologist, anomaly research speed. Well, he's 45, but he is damn good. I'm gonna recruit him with our influence, 50 influence. Let's recruit him and assign him. And we can send now the ship to survey the system. So although I'd prefer a younger one, he has the best ability for exploring systems. And more resources. Have we surveyed the whole system? No, this is going to be the last one. That's a gas giant. Zero habitability, obviously.
System survey complete.
Perfect. We have completed our first objective. Construction finished here. We don't care. So, what we can do now? We can continue exploring, of course. We are gonna send our first science ship to Rovanik. Let's take a look. Don't we have anything here? No. We still need 46 months for the colony ship. Let's continue. And speed up the game a bit. We could go and start building new military vessels, but that will cost us resources, and I'd prefer to keep my resources for building mining outposts. Our first priority should be the minerals, to gather as many minerals as possible. Encounter in Rovanik. We have encountered some form of alien vessels in the Rovanik system. These strange objects have been flagged as Alpha Menas, and then we can learn more about them. Interesting. And Laginchu is in an uproar following the news of unidentified ships sighted in the void. The intentions are known, it will be prudent to assume the worst. Rovanik, let's take a look. 78. No. Alpha Menas. Well, what we can do with this now is go to the situation log and research them. This will keep one of our scientists occupied with that research, and it will slow down his research. Unfortunately, it was the colony ship, but we don't really care. We have to investigate this new species.
Anomaly found.
Perfect. Anomaly level 3. A small rectangular object on the surface of this planet is deflecting all scanning beams like a mirror. Our sensors are unable to determine its material composition. Well, this anomaly has a failure risk of 80%. We are not gonna waste our time here. We're gonna return when he has leveled up a bit, because the anomaly level is 3, so we will need to at least have him at level 3. As it says over here. So, leave B for now and continue surveying the system. It's the same. This might be something very good. In the meantime, let's continue building stuff here. We need 81 minerals to create another mining station, so we will have to wait a couple of months in order to gain more minerals. We're gaining 9 per month. It is very interesting. You have to control your costs. You need to be very careful not to waste energy, minerals, and of course influence. You have to always have these resources in order to proceed. As our science ship scans the surface of issues one, it becomes quite clear that we have found something out of the ordinary. Its composition and history provides it with extra materials that we should take opportunity to gather. We'll surely come across even more irregularities like this as we survey new planets should not underestimate their impact on our expansion. Intriguing. Let's go take a look. No, it wasn't here. It was on issues. What have you discovered? Anyway, continue. There are a lot more interesting stuff that you can discover, even primitive civilizations that you can start observing them. Perfect, the system has been surveyed. It has no resources, unfortunately, only this anomaly. We're gonna continue exploring, and this is, we can of course give multiple commands to survey a lot of systems at the same time. So let's continue. And this is pretty much what you do at the beginning of the game. You explore, construct stuff, and try to colonize new worlds. And later you can start building your power, your military power, in order to defend yourself or simply attack other species, other civilizations. We can build the mining station here, and we are gonna build it. This will give us 2 more minerals every month. What's going on here? Is it not a lot of resources, to be honest, around?
Special project complete.
Perfect. Anomaly? No, let's close this. We have investigated this species, the Tiyanki. Okay, let's proceed, let's continue. I would love to find a habitable world, build a colony ship and show you how to colonize, but that will take a lot of minerals. Science Officer Pagro has leveled up and gained the trait adaptable. Good for her. Good for her. Let's take a look at her. Yeah, it's hard to tell if it's her or he. Adaptable. Leader experience gain plus 15%. That's a really good trait. To make it easier and faster. Encounter. A new encounter. Beta menas. New aliens. Beta menas. Interesting.
Evading hostile fleet.
Okay, excellent. This. Well, our civilian ships, such as construction and science ships, when they encounter other species, military ships of other species, they will try to flee. Unlogical. What that means? That means that this is a habitable world, but we may not have the required technology, such as here, does not have Arctic colonization. And this one here, we currently cannot colonize this world because it's not surveyed. But this is an ocean world, so we can colonize it. Habitability 65%, space squid. It's not the best, but it will do. 65% habitability means that our happiness, the happiness of the people that will live on that planet, can go up to 65% only. But it's a fine example of how you find habitable worlds. Can we build something? Let's keep going. Where are you gonna go? Okay. Let's go survey these systems. And let's go survey these systems as well with you. While waiting to find something interesting, to find a habitat world that we can survey. New aliens. Of course. Let's go to the situation log. We can investigate these, we can research, but I'm gonna leave this first to finish. Let's speed up the game a bit. Okay, you can go server here. In the meantime, we are going to take advantage of our construction ship, and when we have enough resources, enough minerals, we're gonna start building mine stations. So fail risk is at 22%. An abandoned ship has been left to drift aimlessly above this planet. The massive sails protruding from its hull suggests that it relied on solar power to function. Yeah, we can give this a try. We can research and see what will happen. After the research is done, the science ship will continue serving the system. The enemies, the hostiles, not enemies, left Breglar, so we can return. We have discovered an abandoned solar rail ship in orbit around Habrak V. The sublight vessel was built by an unknown culture and appears to be several thousand years old. One of the massive sails has a large tear where some kind of object passed through, most likely a meteoroid, which appears to have disabled the vessel. Although the technology of the ship is severely outdated, it does possess some interesting engineering design choices. So, engineering research gains 60 points, which is excellent. An interesting, albeit primitive design. Stored 55. This will speed up our research a bit. We have 132 minerals, we're gonna keep them. A new anomaly. Signs of activity by an ancient precursor civilization on this inhospitable rock. Let's research. You are not gonna have a problem. Where are they going? They have left Breglar. Excellent. Level up for a leader. She is level 3 now. And I think we can return back to that anomaly and give it a try when they are finished with surveying the systems. We have assigned them survey. The Vultaum Star Assembly. We have recovered artifacts from an ancient alien civilization on Norgon 1. They must have been active in this region of space approximately 12 million years ago, judging by the age of the artifacts. From what they have been able to piece together, our scientists theorize that these aliens, who call themselves the Vultaum Star Assembly, were worm-like annelids, roughly 3 to 4 meters in length, that communicated with each other primarily through vibrations carried along their segmented bodies. Situation log updated. Of course, it is interesting. Everything it is interesting we are finding. Precursors, the Vultaum, and the Vultaum artifacts recovered. None at the moment. We're gonna wait for investigating these guys. Let's keep going. System survey complete. Perfect. Well, you are level 3, right? No, you're level 2. There are some nice resources here, but... And the habitable world. Habitability 100%. This is going to be our target. We are gonna try to build a colony ship and come here, colonize Norgon 2, just to show you how it's done. Pulsar Star. So you're gonna continue, and then you can come back here. And when you're done in Habrak, you're gonna come in Issues. Well, I would normally run the game at the fastest speed. It is a very beautiful game. It is very based in strategy. You have to be very careful with your planning. But now I just wanna rush a bit and show you how to build the colony ship and how to colonize the world. You are done, so go check the anomaly. Research, risk 30%. Okay, you are coming here. Anomaly found. A new anomaly. 22%. A class 12 asteroid orbits this planet. The small planetoid's orbit appears far too stable for its presence to be a natural occurrence. Research it. As you can see, there are many different encounters happening. You never know what will happen to your playthrough. And this is the beauty of Stellaris. And we still haven't found other empires, other species. Then is when really stuff are gonna be interesting. For some reason, someone has towed an asteroid into a stable orbit around Zunur 3rd. The massive engine sections and braking thrusters can still be found on the surface, although they have long since been rendered inoperable. Whoever did this also mined the asteroid for minerals, but these operations were seemingly abandoned shortly after they began. How is our research going? 21 months left. While conducting surface scans of Issues 2, Science Officer Ethog and the crew of the Saska discovered what appears to be an artificially carved slab of rock covered in alien writing. They have not detected any other signs of alien activity on the planet, and exactly how this mural came to be here is a mystery. We have prepared a special project to translate the text. Our first research is complete, so we can continue service speed plus 15% or planned fortification toughness plus 20%. This will also unlock deflectors that we can put on our ship. New anomaly, research. Research, we have assigned it to research. Skill level 3, Pagri is at level 3. Okay. What are you doing? Reset the project. And is the... I have an assigned trans... Cancel? No, no, no. Okay, research it. It won't take long. Maybe we can send someone else. Voltaum asteroid mining base is covered in impact craters from asteroid collision, but one stands out. It appears to have been created through the detonation of some kind of antimatter device. There is evidence elsewhere on the asteroid's surface indicating that it was heavily mined by the Voltaum at some point roughly 12 million years ago. The last crater we found was presumably the location of the mining outpost. Interesting. Updated. Special project complete. And another special project completed. Officer Ithog has managed to partially translate the alien mural discovered on Issus 2. The text contains a staggering amount of data, and the mural evidently serves as some sort of low-tech library. It describes in broad terms the collected technological knowledge of an alien civilization that dominated this region of the galaxy some 80 million years ago. A lot of it is already known to us, but the data does contain several promising leads for technology we had yet to consider. There is enough data here to keep our scientists busy for decades, but we will need an orbital research facility to continue the translation efforts. Let's assign a new research. Defense platform. Pretty self-explanatory, or new ion thrusters that will help our ships go faster, or new armor. Let's go with the ion thrusters. A leader has leveled up. Perfect. Let's keep going. Let's wait for the colony ship. Only 5 months left. We're going quite fast. System survey complete. Let's take a look. Have you surveyed the system? Yes. So let's just send you here. Ah, yeah, we have assigned this already. Okay. Let's send you somewhere else then. Situation updated. Yeah, new species found, Delta Menas, we can research them later. I think we are almost done with our research. 2 only months left. 1 month, and we are pretty much done here. We can now start building a colony ship. And this is very important because we can finally send it and colonize new planets, new worlds. I'm gonna increase our naval capacity. And I'm going to the spaceport to build the colony ship. 315 minerals. Let's complete it and colonize that world. In the meantime, we can use our construction ship, now that we are done with building the colony ship, to build mining stations all over. Mining and research stations in order to take advantage of the resources and the research points all over the bodies, the celestial bodies that have these resources. And like I told you before, we can see here which resources belong to us, which we are taking advantage of. Eventually it will be wise to build a second construction ship if you have the minerals, if you have the space to do it, the slots. You are done here. So let's send you where? Yeah, there were hostiles over there. This is why it fled. Let's go back to our world.
System survey complete.
Bregler has been surveyed. 65%. We keep finding. You can say we keep finding habitat worlds, but we are gonna go for this one that has 100% habitability. Construction ship has finished, so let's keep building stations and taking advantage of this. We have discovered an abandoned solar sail ship in orbit around Ginog 8. The sublight vessel was built by an unknown culture and appears to be several thousand years old. Yeah, it's pretty much the same we have found before. And our colony ship is almost ready. There it is. Negative balance. We are losing energy credits. Okay, let's build a power plant on the surface. We can, of course, build buildings. We have neglected it at the moment, but we are gonna start building them right now. Where can we? Here, there is a growing pop. We need the population on the tile in order to have the buildings working. And we are gonna build a power plant here that will give us 3 energy. So let's take our colony ship and go to Norgon 2, and colonize this planet. We have to choose a starting tile, and I'm gonna choose the one with the food. This one is good, it has the food, but we cannot build there because there's a tile in the active volcano. So let's go over here. There are a ton of stuff in Stellaris. It will be hard to show everything in one only video. We haven't even found other civilizations, other species to communicate and even war them. Someone has leveled up, level 4, perfect. No new traits though. Let's see. There you are. Let's send you here. Survey this system. And continue. Yeah, it is. You have to be careful. You have to not neglect anything. You have to be careful not to go above your limit, not to start losing energy. Encounter new aliens. Let's go to situation log and start researching all these. We have also neglected this because I want to build a colony ship and send it out there so I can show you how to colonize new planets. This is your primary goal when you first start the game. Colonizing new planets. Our colonists are now in the process of building their first settlement. A colony ship has gently touched down at the mouth of a large river delta on one of the several colonies that can be found on Eskog. This temperate forested region will serve as an ideal first landing site. The ship has been permanently converted into the administrative headquarters of the new settlement, and its reactor core is in the process of being removed so that it may serve as the colony's temporary power source. Hundreds of small tents and prefab shelters have sprung up around the former starship's massive hull as colonies begin to disembark in large numbers. The first space squid city on an alien world. A great day for the Squidian Empire. This is pretty much how Stellaris is playing. This is a very small part of the game, unfortunately. I can show you in this video. There is a ton of gameplay you can see later, especially after you have found new civilization, other species, and engage in diplomacy with them, try to communicate with them, war them, destroy them, or have them destroy you. It is an amazing space exploration, primarily than grand strategy game. This was Stellaris. Thank you very much for joining me watching this video. I'm Skid of Love and I will see you next time. Bye bye.